From Channel 3, this is an Eyewitness News update.
Hi everyone, I'm Erin Connolly with some of the day's top stories. Hartford Public Schools are back on track after a ransomware attack brought the first day of school to a screeching halt. No ransom money was demanded, but the hacker or hackers left behind an email address to contact. The mayor doesn't believe any private or personal information was stolen. Officials don't know who was behind the attack, but we do know the FBI is investigating. Classes are now set to start on Wednesday. Now to the latest on the coronavirus here in Connecticut. Governor Ned Lamont says he is worried about spikes at local colleges. Out of 43,000 tests across college campuses over the last few weeks, 166 were positive, a positivity rate of less than 0.5%. So far, so good. And here are the latest statewide numbers since Friday. About 49,000 tests have been conducted. 417 came back positive. That is once again a positivity rate below 1%. Six more people have died and hospitalizations are down by 8. Four more states have been added to Connecticut's travel advisory. Delaware, Maryland, Ohio, and West Virginia have all been put on the list. Anyone traveling to Connecticut from those areas must quarantine for 14 days. Puerto Rico and the U.S. Virgin Islands have both been removed from the advisory. High school football players and their coaches plan to gather again on Wednesday to protest the Connecticut Interscholastic Athletic Conference's decision to cancel this year's football season. This is video from a similar protest held in West Hartford over the weekend. Wednesday night's rally is set for 5 p.m. outside the state capitol in Hartford. A change.org petition circling on social media to bring back football for the fall semester has more than 33,000 signatures.
All right, for your Wednesday, areas of low clouds and fog will give way to a partly sunny, warm, humid day, a high of 85. Showers and a few thunderstorms are in the forecast for Thursday. Highs right around 84, then refreshing weather for Friday and Saturday. Highs in the 70s, lows in the lower 50s, and then more showers and thunderstorms are in the forecast for Sunday. Some much-needed rainfall there. And back to dry, cooler weather Monday and Tuesday.
Eyewitness News is everywhere. Get the latest in-depth headlines anytime on the Channel 3 streaming news app.